You want to support Roller March Unfiltered? Be sure to join our Bring the Funk fan club. Every dollar that you give to us supports our daily digital show. There's only one daily digital show out here that keeps it black and keep it real. It's Roland Martin Unfiltered. Support the Roland Martin Unfiltered daily digital show by going to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com. You can make this possible. The Los Angeles Times did a big story where black folks in Hollywood began to talk about their experiences. Black folks begin to share what they've dealt with, what they've gone through, and the difficulties that they have faced. Same thing has happened in media. The other day, ABC, there was a story that was done on Huffington Post about Barbara Fedida, essentially the number two person at ABC, who allegedly made some racist comments. And now she's on administrative leave, and then they announced there's an external investigation. What we're seeing, the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette, where they have really a rebellion going on among their staff when it comes to pulling a black reporter off of covering the riots. We've seen Bon Appetit, Condé Nast. We've seen Anna Wintour come out with her comments. We've seen other people resign as well. See, while we are in the midst of all of these things happening, you know, there has to be a reckoning that takes place in mainstream media. The Kroner Commission report in 1968 that studied the race riots in 67 said the media played a huge part in that. And I think what has happened is that part of the problem is that nobody reports on media. Nobody really reports on media in the same way. Media outlets right now are asking questions about this company and their staff and this company, what they're doing, and this company and their statements. But what are these media companies doing? The reason that brought my attention is that, and I'm linking this to Mother Emanuel, because I was on Twitter, and go to my iPad. I saw Jason Johnson tweeted this. A friend just reminded me today is the fifth anniversary of Mother Emanuel's assassination. There's been so much black death from police, vigilante violence over the last month. I'd forgotten. I wrote this NBC News piece about the friend I lost that night. And the piece was from 5 years ago. But you have to ask yourself the question, hold up. Here's Jason Johnson writing about a friend, Reverend Clemente Pinckney, who he worked with, who died in Mother Emanuel. Same day with Paul Howard. Of course, is bringing the charges down there in Georgia. Why is Jason Johnson not on the air at MSNBC? 4 months ago, Jason Johnson was taken off of the air. The comments that he made with regards to Nina Turner and Breonna Gray working on the campaign of Bernie Sanders, and there were other people who said, okay, he shouldn't have made those comments. He immediately apologized. 4 months? 4 months, he's still off the air? We're in the middle of the coronavirus pandemic impacting black people. We're dealing with George Floyd. We're dealing with somebody who is a professor at an HBCU, Morgan State, who used to write for The Root, now writes for The Griot, who is one of your more visible faces. We saw him consistently throughout on the air when it came to the impeachment. But what's the deal? How can media demand transparency from other companies, but the media won't be transparent? Why won't MSNBC executives say, what's the deal with Jason Johnson? Did he piss somebody off? Does he still work there? Clearly he does. Why isn't he on the air? I'm raising that point because media must learn to do what they demand of other people. When you watch these news shows, they will demand, where's the transparency from Trump? Where's the transparency from Congress? They'll demand those things. When we at NABJ released our statement, I'm Vice President of Digital, when we released our statement about ABC on Saturday, we said, do an outside investigation and make the results public. I believe, folks, in this moment where we're talking about do black lives matter, mainstream media has to answer the question, do senior black media executives matter? Do black anchors matter? Do black reporters matter? Do black contributors matter? Do black commentators matter? See, media can't be demanding of other people what media won't do themselves. And I still say part of the fundamental problem that we have in this country as to why we really haven't properly addressed a lot of these issues is because mainstream media looks the same as most of these advertising agencies, as most of these corporations, as Congress, as most of these places where we are essentially non-existent. Now, you might say, okay, yeah, but Jason Johnson is a commentator. It's been 4 months. How long must the person be on the sidelines and nobody say anything? This is critical because if our voices are important, don't they need to be on the air? And I want to see more than Jelani Cobb. I want to see more than Eddie Glaude. I want to see more than Jonathan Capehart. I want to see Ellie Mistel. I want to see other brothers and sisters. I want to see more black men commentating on television. I want to see more black men and black women being legal analysts and political analysts and economists and breaking down these various issues. I am not satisfied with what we are seeing. And let me be real clear. I was on MSNBC on Saturday and Sunday. In fact, it was shocking. I've been on the last 3 weeks. I can't tell the last time I was on MSNBC 3 consecutive weeks. This is not about me trying to get a job, because I've been fighting with black folks for a long time. What I am saying is this here. Every single mainstream media corporation in America, including NBC/MSNBC, CNN, Fox News, ABC, NBC, CBS, all of them must be far more transparent and honest about what's happening on the inside, because largely white men are running these organizations and they are deciding who gets to go on and who doesn't. All I'm saying is the brother been on the sideline for 4 months. You think it's long enough? All I'm saying is you got black folks in your operations who ain't been promoted in 10 years. Is that long enough? The reckoning is happening in the advertising industry, in the fashion industry. It's happening in the athletic apparel industry. It's time for it to happen in the media industry, because enough is enough. Because if you dare cover on the air saying Black Lives Matter outside your building, they damn sure should matter on the inside of your building. All right, folks, back to that Roland Martin Uncultured video in just one moment. A sister, she is the designer, the inventor, the creator of these unbelievable great headphones, 360-degree sound 4D headphones. If you do gaming, you can use these headphones. You can actually talk. There's Bluetooth as well. Unbelievable. And so they got a partnership with us, folks, and that is you have a promo code. If you buy these headphones, you get a discount. Go to Ceek.com and use the promo code right there. You see it, RMVIP2020. RMVIP 2020. And so we certainly want to thank Mary Spiel and the folks at Ceek.com.